This is a beautiful, sunny Friday morning, November 15th at the Seattle Temple in Bellevue, Washington. We have just witnessed the marriage and sealing of John and Christine Carey. They were sealed in the temple by Brother Dewey. Witnesses were Christine's father, Brother McCune, and Bishop Steele, John's bishop from Enumclaw. Many of the family and friends joined them in the temple. Some of the roses are still left from the end of summer. John's grandmother, she's been out videoing too. She's just going up now. She in Las Vegas, and she and her husband came for this very special day. What a lovely lady. Some of the family is starting to come out from the temple. Here is John's grandfather from also from Las Vegas. Steele and Brother Wilkes. These people were also part of the wedding party. Christine's father coming out with some of the goodies. Brother Don Lockhart, and both John and Christine have lived with Brother Lockhart for a short time at a time. There's the grandparents from, I believe it's Nebraska, Jen's parents. It's nice that they came such a long ways for this special day. Bride's mother. And Brother and Sister McCune have brought Lay's for this very special day for the grandparents. Here comes Carol and Alan with their Lay's. And here comes Mr. and Mrs. John Carey. Christine McCune Carey. Being greeted by their loved ones here.
This is what you guys.
brother and sister McCune, Christine's parents, her grandparents, John and Christine, Carol and Alan, and John's grandfather. I don't know where the grandma went. There she is. John, would you like to introduce your wife?
World, I'd like to meet my brand new wife, Christine Carey.
Wonderful. And who are you with, Christine?
I'm with John Carey, my husband.
Good. What? How do you feel about today? That answers it. Good. Good. Better. Look at their flowers.
Yes, I don't want Jenny in here.
Yes. Beautiful Jenny.
Now, who's Jenny?
Her best friend.
This is your friend from Bellingham.
Pretend you're happy.
You're probably looking all different right directions. Here. I'm looking at Alan. You're looking
know
at Jenny.
You know how to go call that restroom, huh?
Yes.
Get a shot of us, honey.
The bride.
Get in front of the fountain there.
Yeah.
In
front of the fountain.
Going down there.
Oh, what a shot.
I'm gonna fall and everything will be ruined.
What a shot.
Camera has to go over.
Picture, Mom and Dad.
They're coming.
All right.
Okay. Come on, Tutu.
Come on, Tutu. Okay, one, two, three.
Go.
Not flicking, honey.
You got it close. My face is going to hurt by the time Tutu gets over. Right.
Mom, come on down. We want to. Tutu.
Yeah.
Come on down. We'll get Tutu. You and Dad down here.
You can be exhausted by next week.
We need.
There's a level.
You're going to get in there too, right?
Now you're pulling on my veils. Christine!
No, it's
just for her. That one went. Hey, what do you think?
She said, I wanted one just to
stand over here. Both of you stand on this side. Yeah. Should I straighten out here?
Oh, wait a minute, let's straighten out her.
Careful, maybe.
Following me, she was not following.
Oh, that's nice. I can't see Brother McCune. Step out a little bit.
That's the best picture possible.
Now I can't see Sister McCune. There. There we are.
All right.
Wait a minute.
Mom's
yeah,
got
well,
it. I've got it.
Here we go. Yeah, he's seeing everybody. Right here.
Do you want
okay, now let's get.
You
want
a parent?
No. We want you.
Another one.
That was nice.
My veil.
And just to let you know, it's about 20 till 12.
Fine.
Thanks, that's nice.
Right here. Pretend you're happy again.
A year later.
Okay, ready? Aim. Fire!
Hey! Into that one, yet?
Yeah, right here you
go. Just me and my mother.
Okay.
One, two, three. You want one of these, Carol? Here we go.
Get over there.
What now?
Get the two moms with the bride. That looks good.
Oh,
there
you go.
There we are.
Push my flash down, would you? Thanks.
Yeah, I think we're good.
Hi.
Is there any possible combination we didn't?
You get the sun in your lens that way, you're going to have a dark picture.
There's the sun.
You will?
Well, it's in the picture this time,
though. Why don't you guys get on this side of me? Or not? Like, yeah, you can do it. We gotta talk a little bit about today so we get it on video. Ah!
Oh, here's our bride and groom sitting out here in this nice little park area. Tell us how you feel today, Mr. Carey.
Wonderful. This is awesome. We've taken... We've been waiting for it. It's gone real fast though. And I'm glad that it's finally here. And I'll be glad when all the rest of this is over and we can get back home and start our new life together. I'm looking forward to it.
How'd you feel about the ceremony, Christine?
It was beautiful. It was beautiful. Not what I expected. It was really lovely. I cried. I think it was when he actually said that we were married, when he actually finished it up, you know, and that's when I started to cry really hard.
Okay. Tell us how you met. And how long you've known each other.
Not very long.
How long is that?
3 months, yeah.
3 months.
His mother set us up on a blind date. She called me one night and asked me if I wanted to go out with her son, and I thought, oh, sure, what the heck. I figured he'd probably be a nerd, but I knew I would get free dinner, and so I decided to go ahead and do it. And he, what were you thinking?
I thought, my mom's a very charitable person, so I figured she had this poor young lady that didn't ever get a date and wanted me to do her a favor, and I thought, well, I'm a nice guy, but I'll take her out.
And we were engaged a month and 4 days after that.
A month and 4 days.
Right. After that first date, yep.
Good. Tell us about when John proposed to you, Christine.
Oh. Early in the morning, when I was visiting one weekend, he came over and we went hiking. At about 7-8 o'clock in the morning, we went hiking up Mount Peak, which is a little tiny mountain in Utah. And it took about an hour going up, and it was this hike straight uphill, and we got to the top, and it was a foggy morning, and we sat on the rocks, and I think we said a prayer, and we were just talking, and he had told me that he had something he wanted to talk to me about, and I had gotten the idea it wasn't really good, and I was really prepared for the worst, and he said he'd been doing a lot of thinking, and had gone to the temple, and had made some decisions, and I was holding my breath because I wasn't expecting a whole lot. And then he said that he decided he wanted me to be his wife. And I about had a heart attack. it was the last thing I expected. And he planned it that way because he knew that I would, he didn't want it to be something that I expected. He didn't want it to be an agreement. He wanted to be old-fashioned about it and actually propose to me. And it was beautiful. It was really beautiful the way he did it.
And she accepted then, John.
Yeah.
Yeah, I threw my arms around him and cried.
Yeah. Home going to be?
In my hometown of Enumclaw. We have a nice little apartment already set up. She's been living there. Nice little one bedroom with a fireplace and a nice view of Mount Rainier. She's a very good housekeeper and I'll enjoy living.
And a good cook.
Yes, very.
Okay. Let's have a kiss with the bride and groom, and then we'll let them be on their way, Mr. and Mrs. Carey.
My love, God, I'm so good. Say that one more time.
Yeah. They ought to play the wedding song.
Okay, let's go.
There's John and Christine cutting their cake.
Make one more.
Get out of there, Carol. Oh, don't smash it in each other's face, please.
One more time.
One more.
I don't like being killed.
Okay. Well,
but I will tell
her.
And her father to dance. And after they get started, you can all dance.
Next.
Unforgettable. That's what you are.
Bride and her dad, and there's John and his mom, Carol and John and Wes and Christine. It's a happy couple. And that's Alan and Lindy singing. And there's the mother of the bride and her dad dancing together.
Grandpa James.
Hey, No.
You guys are good.
The bride and the groom. Oh, I'm sorry, the bride and the groom.
We are twain flesh.
They were playing the first time we danced, and I knew as we swayed to the music and to each other. I
I hope you're ready.
tell.
Love him to death.
Yep, short, muscular.
I think we look good. Right. He's got a girlfriend.
Oh, y'all look good together.
Come on, you just told Mom that.
Oh. Do that again, what did you say?
Oh, nothing.
Good dancer.
Oh, good. Who is this?
This is my grandmother.
Hello. Hi. How you doing? All right, smile for the camera.
This is my new grandpa.
All right, all right. We want to catch you.
Listen, Al.
Hello.
Hello.
And we get to see the behind-the-scenes look. Here's the behind-the-scenes look. Yeah.
Right,
yeah,
okay. Oh, this is a cameraman.
I get to kiss.
Wow, you got a nice camera there.
Yeah, you do too.
Ooh, nice lens there.
Huh. Yeah, I take one of these deals.
Oh, yeah, that's a nice little foamy black one there. I like that. Huh.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Hey. Get her.
See you later, Mr. Cameraman. What's the night video? What's going on, John?
I'm married.
Ah. Oh.
Thank you for coming.
I have to say, it's definitely not a comedy book. This is better than Christmas.
Yeah.
Well, you know the presents? I should get married just to have all these presents.
Yeah, it's a long commitment.
Tom on
so who are we going to show this to anyway?
Oh, we're going to sell it to the highest bidder.
Okay.
Tony! Tony! Now you have to say the kids.
Hi. All right. Who's this?
She's got some cards in
here. John will. Congratulations.
Hey, John, you get the keys all the
time. Grab your mother or your wife.
Do I get a hug?
Yeah. Where's Nicole? Good question.
Well,
you guys have lots of fun. I bet they will.
They're not going to love you.
Hello.
Are they driving to the dirt tub?
No. They're going
to get really good for the hotel.
Gotcha. This is my brother, by the way. Make sure that
901.
This is my brother.
I think we got
his sister.
Oh, that is emergency number 911.
Wait a minute, I can still forget the condom on your back.
Goodbye.
Where's Nicole for all your
but get everything fixed.
Oh, yes, the car, yes.
And remember, don't drive more than 80 miles an hour. I hear you've kind of got a heavy foot.
Bible.
You gotta keep going.
Okay,
let's
we're
go,
going.
Let's go, let's go.
I did.
Okay, I get the back seat.
Lock the keys in the car?
You want to get in on the
car? Yeah, I don't want to see that. No, I don't want to get in there.
Here, let me help you.
Look, the license plate says I'm being kidnapped.
Woo! All right. Okay, so what are his last words?
Okay, let me just get a picture of you guys in the car.
If I kiss you?
No, tell us what your plans are.
Get in the car.
Okay, kind of look out a little bit. Light up your head so we can see. Hi! Goodbye, we're going now.
We're out of here.
Okay.
See ya. Have a good life.
Bye.
And there goes the tin cans, folks.
Nick and Eli has spoiled.
Bye.
We're gonna.
They're gonna get a ticket for littering.
Let's go.
So what are the last words of the night?
Well, I always have the pessimistic point of view. I bet they're gonna go down the road, get stopped for littering or something from the toilet paper. And they put shaving cream on the back of the car, which destroys the paint job.
And the police are gonna the car's gonna break down on the interstate, right?
Yeah, probably. Once they
Wanna
get
drink?
Oh, okay. No.
Once they get to wherever they're going, the police will bust in and ask if they're married and stuff. I'm sure there must be a good side, though. Yeah, he got a nice ring. That's a good side.
There you go.
Why'd you go lay down?
Yeah. Oh, you're dad, I'd go to sleep and I wouldn't get any pizza.
Oh. Hi, Joe. When did you get here, honey?
He's helping out there in the car.
There's nothing left. Oh.
30 minutes less or free?
No, $4 off.
Well, let's sit. Jared, you want to get us to the top of the stairs, and I'll hand you the presents, and you can just put them up there, because I don't need anything
else. That's a library book.
Yours?
Look at all this. I wish you'd come and open it.
Put it in there.
They should have come over here and opened all the presents so I could look at them before the reception, before the honeymoon, don't you think?
Yeah.
That sounds like a good idea to me.
Do you have any paper that's just plain?
The stuff in the garbage bags is stuff.
Oh, thank you. I could use a compliment because I sure worked hard. I cleaned up the whole attic and it's organized and everything looks good. good. Joey, you want to hand me a smaller present? Okay. I'll hand them over.
You mean you really and truly did?
The whole thing is.
So now you know. Now you know where your stuff is.
Yeah.
Hey, Carol.
That's the whole house.
You can't do about 1,000 things at once.
You can do that at once.
I don't know why you can't do 1,000 things at once, Joey. You're a genius. This is everybody putting the presents up in the attic for the newlyweds.
Some of these presents don't have the cards have fallen off. So I don't know.
I think there was one card out there that had money in it, and that's all. I don't know. I said be sure and put this there.
Here we go. Yeah, be real careful. Cards don't fall off. See, they didn't put anything on top.
Just stand up all the ones with cards on.
Carrie. At the Dixon home. Yeah, it's for you. Oh, just.
Hi.
How does it feel like being married after a week, huh?
Great.
John told me the other day he's handcuffed now.
Did she really say that?
No, that's my dog.
Okay. There we go.
There's a man that they all stayed with and straightened them all out.
You bet.
Bishop Steele, right there. Any good words for the newlyweds, Bishop?
Prosper and be happy.
Prosper and be happy, huh? Many children, huh?
Oh, is that? Did you give them a sign?
The sign. Well,
yeah,
I can't do that.
The
they
sign.
Indulgence. So I can pick it up.
Yeah,
you
know, I
think
that
way
I
can
pair
them with the
tree.
I
can
stop
doing
it.
Yeah, because
I
hadn't.
Yeah.
Exactly how it is.
Some of these things, I just
hate
them.
You bet your cameras.
I
was okay.
You looked great,
though, Peter Martin. Oh, I bet I did. Yeah, right. Good morning, we're doing last.
What's wrong, Evelyn? You like to be in the picture, don't you? Sure you do.
Of course. I'm happy for John and for Steve.
Right.
Alan, Carol, and all those nice people.
Right.
I don't have to buy Steve's
hand to her. And I'm
letting
her.
Good news, I have Thanksgiving next week.
I do anything you want.
The woman writes your charcoal. Sure, take my car. I drive a piece of crap.
Someone
get on
table with your camera.
Oh,
Grace, see the movie on John.
3 or 4 days. 2 months.
What are you saying? Mm. Let's go
take
Carol.
We can get a hold of her, but okay. Well, we found out her hours is she gets home about 7:30. So we go out.
Obeyed me. And when he disobeys Christine from now on, he will get hurt.
You always draw blood, Brother Dixon?
When he disobeys, like, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. This is a very solemn occasion here.
Probably too much light in the background.
It looks like he's asking his hand in marriage.
Band-aid is never going to come off. I'll cherish it forever.
Kiss her.
What ship do you run there?
This is 1 week after the wedding yet. They still like each other.
Maybe this much.
Just that much.
2 weeks.
2 weeks? No.
Don't they? Whenever James comes up, doesn't he walk over here?
They usually ride their bikes over.
Don't.